Welcome to the Success Talk Show, the podcast for ambitious leaders who want to get their best results and create a workplace for their teams to thrive. Each week, we share practical advice to help you accelerate your success and grow as an inspiring leader. Now, here's your host, Leadership Success Coach, Donna Sirianni.
Welcome to another episode of the Success Talk Show. This is Donna Sirianni, Leadership Success Coach and founder of Success Compass Academy. In this episode, I'll share tips with you on how to leverage your personal brand to achieve your goals. Now, I've developed a fantastic online program within my Success Compass Academy that takes you through this process step by step. And you can find out more about this program by going to myownsuccesscompass.com. That's myownsuccesscompass.com. myownsuccesscompass. myownsuccesscompass.com. Okay, so exactly what is your success compass? It's the powerful combination of elements that guide you in choosing a path to follow and accelerating your success. I view this as one of the foundations for your professional success. So once you have your own unique success compass, it can really help you to clarify a direction to go in, a choice to make, decide what opportunity is the right opportunity for you, but also accelerate your progress so that you're achieving your goals and bringing your vision into reality. Now, one of these critical elements that's part of what I call your success compass is your personal brand. So in this episode, I'll give you a few tips to move forward. But before we go any further, I'd like for you to identify a specific goal that's on your mind right now so you can keep it in mind as I go through this material. Now, maybe you're thinking about a promotion that you have on your mind that you're working towards, or perhaps you're wondering what your next role should be. Maybe you're at a point where you're feeling like you don't have as much of a challenge. Maybe you're confused or a little frustrated, maybe a little disappointed, maybe even a little bored with how things are going. So you might be wondering, what should my next role be? What should I be aiming for? Or it could be you're quite happy with where you are, but you want to improve your leadership skills so you can make an even bigger contribution. So whatever your goal is, keep that in mind as we go through today's episode. Now, first, I just want to address what is a personal brand and why does it matter? So simply put, your personal brand is your reputation. It's what people think of when they think of you. Now, the concept of personal branding was, first inspired by Tom Peters, the author of In Search of Excellence, and it was as a result of his article in Fast Company back in 1997. And back in that article, he said, quote, "All of us need to understand the importance of branding. We are CEOs of our own companies, me incorporated. To be in business today, our most important job is to be head marketer for the brand called you." Okay, so one of the reasons Tom Peters urges us all to be our own head marketer is that the days of being with one company for an entire career are long gone. Now, it's really become the new normal that, most of us change jobs far more frequently. Companies these days are restructuring, merging, being acquired, reinventing themselves. And according to the U.S. Department of Labor, a person will change jobs 11 to 12 times before they reach the age of 48. So that's a significant shift in the workplace. So to be successful, you need to always be thinking of yourself as the CEO of your own company. He calls it Me Inc. or Me Incorporated. So when you think about branding, right, he's saying the same branding that applies to a company applies to each of us. So think about a company that you most admire and love to do business with. So what brands come to mind? If you're thinking about taking a fun family vacation, you might immediately think of Disney. If you're thinking about what could one of the safest cars be that you could drive, you might think of Volvo. Or if you really want a stylish pair of new sneakers, you might automatically look for Nike, right? Well, the same is true for you. Whether you realize it or not, you are a brand. If I mention your name to someone, someone perhaps that works closely with you, what would immediately come to mind? Would they think change agent, that person's a problem solver, or they're an inspiring leader? So everything you say, every action you take, how you present yourself, how you interact with others, it all shapes your personal brand. So it could happen in reverse too. If I said, so what do you think of when you think of Disney, right? You're going to think family entertainment. What do you think of when you think Volvo? Oh, safety, right? And then Nike, you might immediately think, just do it. So it goes both ways. So what's important about clarifying your personal brand? Well, the real reason why I'm so passionate about this subject is because people will make decisions about whether or not you're the best person for an opportunity based on what they know about you. So let's imagine the following scenario. Let's assume you know someone, you know, pretty well, who's closely connected to a decision maker for a new opportunity. And it could be for a new project, new assignment, working with a new client. Maybe it's a new role altogether. Maybe it's becoming the leader of a new organization or, you know, tackling a problem that needs to be solved. Now, the person that you know quite well finds out about this opportunity, and it's a perfect opportunity for you. It's something you would love to take on. The big question is, will they think of you? Will you be top of mind? Now, if the answer is yes, then in that instance, that circumstance, your personal brand is spot on, because whoever becomes aware of that opportunity can immediately connect the dots between what is needed and what you would bring to the table. They're able to put two and two together and say, ah, I know the perfect person. I know just who could take this on, right? But if, on the other hand, they don't think of you, it doesn't even occur to them that you'd be a good fit for this opportunity, then, this might be a clue there's a disconnect, right? It's possible that you don't have a strong enough brand to really stand out and be top of mind. Maybe this person that you think you know quite well, they don't really know what's on your mind, in your heart, about what you'd really like to do. Maybe they don't have enough insight into what you're bringing to the table. So that's possible. Or maybe your colleague doesn't think you're well suited for the role. That could be the disconnect. You think this would be perfect for you, but they don't really see it as a good fit. So has this ever happened to you? Let me ask you this. Has it ever happened to you that you've seen someone else get an opportunity and you think to yourself, darn it, I would have loved to have done that. And I'm wondering, geez, how come no one thought of me for that opportunity? Now, has that ever happened to you? I'm sure it's happened to all of us where we're wondering, why didn't I get picked for that? So it does matter to make sure that what's top of mind for other people is a really clear sense of who you are, what you're good at, what you stand for, what you contribute, and what you would actually bring to the table, the results that you could achieve. Now, another example of where this shows up is certainly in job searches and recruiting, right? So a statistic that I find really interesting is that 70% of all roles are filled through a personal connection. So your personal brand, you know, it's your reputation, what you're known for, it really can be influenced by many things. And we're not just talking about a job search, it's any match between an opportunity and what you have to offer and what you're hoping for. So you might be wondering, how do I influence this? What can I do? So before we dive into that, I just want to share with you a couple of other ingredients that really can shape your personal brand. So I've already mentioned, you know, your personal brand, it's how you interact with others, it's your communication style, it might even be the type of people that you hang out with, how you dress. It's really everything about you that forms an impression, that leaves a lasting impression on people who know you. Okay, so your personal brand is made up of lots of things, including what you're good at, right, your strengths. And so you might want to ask yourself, you know, how self-aware are you about where you make your biggest contribution? What are you really good at? What do other people most appreciate about you? And when they come to you for help, what is it? Now, another ingredient is your values, right? What's important to you? What's not negotiable? How is what you say and what you do consistent with those values? So in terms of values, I might think about reliability, trust, you know, being trustworthy, committed, collaborative, open-minded, open to new ideas, creative, innovative, strategic. These are just attributes that I might think of when I think of you. So how clearly, how strongly do you live by a set of values in the workplace? And if I know you, will I see that you act consistent with those values? Now, another element is passions. You know, whether it's inside of work or outside of work, what are those things that you're passionate about? And what do other people know about you? It could be that you're an animal lover and you donate time to a rescue center on the weekends, or you're a history buff or a photographer. You know, what's interesting and exciting to you? And it could be that something special that people really associate with you. Like, for example, I did have a client who was a history buff, and he also had it as a strength. So when he was working on a project assignment with a client, he always wanted to know the history, the context for how things had evolved to the current state. How did things get from where they were to today? So being a history buff just adds another little twist of something unique that's interesting and certainly interesting to that person. So what are your passions? It could be learning, taking on new things, solving problems, whatever it is. But what is it that you're passionate about that you certainly would love for people that you work closely with to know about you? Now, when I work with my clients, we typically will focus on specific goals, and then we look at how their personal brand, along with strengths, values, passions, because, you know, that all comprises your success compass. Your personal brand is one of those elements. So we try and connect the dots between specific goals they're working towards that they want to achieve and this success compass, right? So we'll guide them in a certain direction, help them clarify what choices will be the best ones for them. So when you think about your personal brand, just having it is not enough. You want to put it to good use, have it help you leverage your personal brand to achieve specific goals. So let me give you a couple examples. I had a client who wanted to be seen as more strategic instead of simply really good at running operations. So what she needed to do is to make it more visible in her interactions every day and with key people that in fact she was strategic, and she could demonstrate that by what she focused on, topics she brought up in the meetings, what she chose to make recommendations, and the work that she was doing. So she not only ended up getting the ideal job, she was also invited to join some senior level meetings that very few people were able to join to help architect future initiatives. So it was a major win, big shift, really changed everything. But it really required that she get really clear on her personal brand and then make deliberate choices to act authentically, because we're going to talk about that in a minute. And other people could see her more clearly for what she could contribute. And then she was able to accelerate progress and achieve the level, the position, and the contribution that she most wanted to make. So I'll give you another example. I had another client who was concerned about where he'd land after a big reorganization at his company. And as a result of getting super clear about his own personal brand, he was able to be much more deliberate about how he was interacting with others, how he was spending his time, and the kinds of activities that he volunteered for, so that he could make sure people could really see him for what was most important to him. And again, it has to be authentic. But he did end up with a promotion, a much more visible role, really excited and really eager to make a bigger impact. So I mentioned the word authentic a couple times because this is not about coming up with a story and some marketing and sort of fabricating somebody that you want to be that is not truly you. It has to be authentic. But what can really happen is, and I don't know if this is true for you, it's certainly been true for me and most of the clients that I've supported, you're so busy day to day, head down, trying to get so much work done, working with your teams, navigating challenges, you've got your plate is really full, that you often don't have time to just step back, do some self-reflection, put these pieces of the puzzle together so that you can be more deliberate. So it's not as though you're fabricating a brand, saying, I'm going to wake up one morning and say, you know what? I'm not very strategic, but that's what I'd like to be. It's got to be authentic to what is really true for you, what you're good at, what you want to be known for, what you stand for, your values, your passions. All of that has to really honestly reflect who you are. Because if it's not authentic, people will see the disconnect and they won't trust you. They'll say, you know, he says that he's really excited about and passionate about being a problem solver. But you know, when we go to him with problems, He's nowhere to be found, hides in his office, doesn't roll up his sleeves, isn't a team player, doesn't want to join us. So again, it has to be authentic because it will directly affect the trust that other people have in you and them wanting to make sure that you're included in the right opportunities. Okay. Now, at this point, you might be thinking, okay, I get it. I see why I need to clarify my personal brand, but how do I actually decide what my personal brand should be? So I've mentioned that the key to having an authentic personal brand is being self-reflective and discovering what it is today. And you can use that as a starting point. So your first step will be to gain clarity because you're not just going to, as I said earlier, you're not going to just wake up one morning and say, you know, I think I want to be seen as creative. I want to be seen as highly innovative and a thought leader, when in fact, that's not at all true for you. You're really good at executing, getting things done, putting procedures in place and something, organizing, creating systems, organizing, and it's not so much about innovation. So let me give you an example. If you want to be known as a change agent, let's just take that as an example. Is that how people already see you? Now, if how people see you today is consistent with how you want to be seen, they see you as a change agent. When there's some big initiative where it's going to require a lot of change across the organization, you're the first person that's top of mind for those initiatives, then congratulations. It sounds like there's some alignment between what you're good at, what you want to be known for, and the kinds of opportunities coming your way. If you have that kind of alignment, fantastic. Congratulations. That means that your words, your actions, your behaviors, they're all consistent with that personal brand. That's great. Now, if people don't see you the way you see yourself, then it is a red flag to dig a little deeper. You might want to ask, you'd ask yourself, is this disconnect really the result of a lack of awareness in how you show up every day in the workplace? Or, you know, is it pointing to something else? You know, you don't want to think that you're delusional, right? You want to have a pretty good sense of what you're good at, where you contribute, and so on. But the red flag is something to pay attention to. I would say for the coaching clients that I work with, I would say most often, probably 90% of the time, what happens when people try to uncover their personal brand is they find it validating, inspiring, it's motivating because people see the value and what they bring, and sometimes see it even more clearly than my client. So typically this is an exercise that really can yield dividends because once you're clear, then how you navigate choices becomes that much easier. Now, I've had many coaching clients, for example, say they want to be known as someone who develops their team and mentors other leaders. However, if they fail to commit the time and energy to do it, then there's a disconnect between what they want to be known for and what the reality is. Now, that doesn't mean there's a flaw in their character. It just might mean they've got a little bit of a wake-up call. If you say you want to be a leader who's known for developing others, you've got to put your money where your mouth is, or another cliche, right? You got to walk the talk because it may be genuinely something you're committed to, but your actions don't show it. You never have time for anyone. You're always too busy. You cancel the appointments for one-on-ones at the last minute. It seems like you're really only worried about yourself, right? These would all be things that would be, these would not reflect well on your personal brand if, in fact, what you want to be known for is developing others. Now, it could be you have really the best of intentions, but once you see that red flag, you dig a little deeper, you might say, you know what? I can see that I need to make sure my actions really do reflect this commitment, right? It's a passion of mine. I'm going to make changes. I'm going to decide how much time each week I'm going to put on it. So that's just an example of how you can have something that you think is your personal brand, what you want to be known for, but you do need to do a reality check and see, is that really how you're showing up? And when it is accurate and aligned, then that's where the magic happens because now others see you that way. They'll gravitate toward you. They know that what you're saying and doing is consistent with who you really are and your behavior. So, and again, that's where you're going to really accelerate progress. So let's shift and talk about how do you leverage your personal brand to achieve your goals? So tip number one is you've got to gain clarity on what your brand is today. That's your starting point. Now, the best way is to get anonymous 360 feedback on what others most appreciate about you. And I'll tell you more about that in a second. But another way that you could do it is you could take a look at past performance reviews for clues on what others have said about your contribution. So maybe depending on how your past performance reviews were written, they may have taken into account feedback that came from colleagues, employees, your bosses, etc. Right? So those documents could be really useful. Now, if you've saved emails from other people where they've given you feedback on something that they appreciated, those can also be helpful. Now, I don't know about you, but I do save those emails. Anytime I get an email from a client, and I certainly did this in my corporate life as well, I like to save those emails because sometimes if they're detailed enough, it can give you a few clues as to what you've done that other people appreciated that you could do more of. Now, another thing you can do is you can ask others who you know and trust for feedback. You can say, you know, I want to increase my contribution. I would love to get your feedback on what you see as my strengths, what you most appreciate about me, etc. And you can do this through email or a survey. Now, the downside of the direct email approach is it's not anonymous. So I question sometimes, even if it's somebody you really know, like, and trust, how comfortable they're going to feel being, you know, brutally honest. And even if they're in a rush, if they might miss some things. So that's better than nothing, but that is not my favorite approach. My favorite approach is to do this with an online 360 personal branding survey tool that I use in my program because it's designed just for this purpose. It's anonymous. It provides in-depth, structured look at what others most appreciate about you. Now, it will take people probably about 15 minutes to fill it out. Generally, you would send this out to family, friends, colleagues, bosses, employees, even clients, and you would send it to as many people as you could. You could even send it to 50, 60 people or more, because what you're trying to do is look across really all different areas of your life, people that you know, it could be that you've known for years, at other places you've worked. And what I love about this tool is the information you get back is so rich because it will really tell you what are those top 10 attributes. Now, it's got lots of other information in it, but I'm just highlighting one aspect of it. What are those top things that everybody would agree they most appreciate about you? Right? This report consolidates that information and presents it to you in a way that you can use that information to really gain some insight into your personal brand. It's not you just waking up one day saying, you know, I think I want to be seen as a strategic thought leader. It's people telling you that have worked with you side by side. Here's how we see you. These are the things we really admire and appreciate about you. Okay. So I love it. And it can be really valuable in giving you clues as to what you can pay even more attention to and what you can leverage. Because if you find out things about yourself that other people really appreciate about you, those are the things you want to do more of, that you can accentuate and play up in how you position yourself for other opportunities. Now, in my program, I walk you through how to clarify your strengths, values, passions, your personal brand, your vision, and the goal setting process to bring that vision to life. So if you want to know, as I mentioned earlier at the beginning of this episode, if you want more information, you can go to myownsuccesscompass.com to find out more about that program. So tip number two is you need to figure out what makes you unique. It's trying to answer the question, why you? So as a result of getting 360 feedback and gaining clarity on your strengths, values, passions, and all the things I mentioned, you can use this information to pinpoint how you're different. What makes you unique? Why you? What are you contributing that nobody else can contribute? For example, if you're looking to position yourself for that great opportunity, what's special about what you have to offer? Now, I will tell you, over the years, there's a few phrases that everybody says as if it distinguishes them, right? They'll say, oh, I'm hardworking, results-oriented, team player, collaborative, good communicator. Well, wouldn't you want everyone to have these qualities? Do you want anybody on your team who's not a team player, results-oriented, collaborative, right? So you need to dig deeper. Your challenge is to find out in a lot more granularity, a lot more clarity, what makes you unique. Now, it could be, once you do this sort of deeper dive, that you have some qualities around, it could be things like being analytical, humor, storytelling, truth teller, right? Being able to really tell it straight in a way that is so powerful and yet people can really accept it. You're able to really deliver bad news in such a positive way. I mean, whatever it is, right? What makes you unique? And you, because whatever it is, like you might be good at networking, influencing, building relationships, being empathetic, you know, understanding another person's point of view, handling stress, whatever it is, you may take it for granted because it comes naturally to you, right? So you may discount it. But the challenge here is you're finding what makes you unique in sort of a detailed way. You don't want it to be this general statement that, you know, anybody could say, oh, I'm such a hard worker. Well, you know, I think everybody would say that, right? So the next tip, tip number three, is once you have gotten feedback on what others appreciate about you, you've figured out what makes you unique. At this point, you probably have some notes, a list, maybe even pages of notes. What you really need to do next to decide, based on everything that you've uncovered, what do you want to be known for? From everything you've uncovered, what do you want your reputation to be? Now, you may have that long list, but to have the greatest impact, you want to boil it down to what most resonates with you. And I've mentioned a couple things. I tend to mention about a handful of things because they're recurring themes. I hear people talk about being a thought leader, change agent, good at mentoring people, developing other leaders, improve their communication skills. There's a communications role that they want to have, etc. So what do you most want to be known for? So remember I said, imagine a scenario, there's a perfect opportunity, someone that really knows you well finds out about it, and you want to be top of mind. What is it? What would you want to be top of mind? So when they trip over it or discover it, they'd go, oh, I know just the person to take this on. What would that be? Now, tip number four is to communicate your brand to others. Now, once you've decided what you want your brand to be, and you have some specific goals that you're striving for. Remember, we started at the beginning of, is it a promotion, a new role, make a bigger contribution, whatever it is. You need to communicate on a regular and consistent basis what it is that is your brand to make sure that every day you're living it authentically. Remember, I mentioned the example is if you want to be known as someone who develops other leaders, how are you demonstrating that? You can communicate it by words. Oh, I love developing other leaders. But those are empty words if you don't actually walk the talk. If you don't actually do it and show that commitment and demonstrate it, then it's not meaningful, right? There's the disconnect. So whatever it is you've decided, how can you live it and breathe it every day in your emails, in your presentations, in casual conversation, in the work that you do, interactions with colleagues, right? What are all the ways that you can live your personal brand such that people see it? Not only they see it's authentic, it's genuine, it's definitely you, it's your personality, but they also see you're committed to a set of values. And every day, how you show up at work, if someone were to say, you know, I need to find a mentor, who could I speak with that might be a good mentor? Everybody would instantly think of you, right? Oh, you've got to talk to him or her because they're a great mentor. They love developing other people, right? Unless you have that as a sort of guiding principle in your own work life, other people, they may not see it, know it. You need to communicate it. You communicate it through both words, actions, and behavior. So those are the tips. You need to clarify your personal brand by starting with what is it today? Figure out what makes you unique. Decide what you want to be known for. And communicate your brand to others through your words, your actions, your behavior. Okay, so those are just a few tips to get you moving in that direction. Now, if you'd like to take this further and really go through the step-by-step process, be sure to check out the link for my program that I mentioned. The link is myownsuccesscompass.com. And there you'll find more information about what the program includes. And, you know, I really invite you to do this for yourself because this is one of those areas where once you create a foundation, you can really leverage this throughout your career. All the ingredients, all the elements of your success compass can really help you with decision making, navigating career choices, even influencing how you interact with others on a day-to-day basis so that you're seen as an effective and inspiring leader. So anyway, if you found this episode helpful, be sure to subscribe in iTunes to the Success Talk Show. Thank you for listening and have a great day.